A Bucket of Blood 1959 is a low-budget American comedy horror film directed by Roger Corman and written by Charles B. Griffith. Set in the beatnik culture of its time, the film stars Dick Miller. Produced on a mere $50,000 budget and shot in just 5 days, it embodies the typical low-budget aesthetics associated with Corman's work. The story revolves around a naive busboy at a bohemian cafe who accidentally becomes a celebrated sculptor by covering a dead cat in clay to hide his misdeed. When pressured to create more art, he turns to murder. This film marked the first of three comedy collaborations between Corman and Griffith, followed by The Little Shop of Horrors, which used the same sets as A Bucket of Blood.
I will talk to you of art, for there is nothing else to talk about. For there is nothing else. Life is an obscure hobo bumming a ride on the omnibus of art. Burn gas, buggies, and whip your sour cream of circumstance and hope. And go ahead and sleep your bloody heads off. Creation is. All else is not. What is not creation is Graham crackers. Let it all crumble to feed the creator. The artist is. All others are not. A canvas is a canvas, or a painting. A rock is a rock, or a statue. A sound is a sound, or is music. A creature is a creature, or an artist. John, Joe, Jake, Jim, Jerk, dead. They were not born before they were born. They were not born. Where are Leonardo, Rembrandt, Ludwig? Alive. They were born. Bring on the multitude with a multitude of fishes. Feed them to the fishes for liver oil, to nourish the artist. Stretch their skins upon an easel, to give him canvas. Crush their bones into a paste, that he might mold them. Let them die, and by their miserable deaths become the clay within his hands, that he might form an ashtray, or an ark. All that is comes through the eye of the artist. The rest are blind fish swimming in the cave of aloneness. Swim on, you maudlin, muddling, maddened fools. And dream that one bright and sunny night, some artist will bait a hook and let you bite upon it. Bite hard and die. In his stomach, you are very close to immortality.
Walter, what are you doing here?
I was looking at Carla's picture.
Why, I pay you to look at pictures. Come on, get to work.
I was just looking.
There are empty cups all over the place. Clear them out.
You shouldn't be so rough on him, Leonard.
Say, Walter.
All right. There
you go, Kurt. Yes, man. How you make it?
Fine, man. How about you?
Good enough.
Valdez, Vice.
Yeah, LaCroix checking in. Lou took over a couple of minutes ago.
Anything new at the door?
Well, nothing you can pound nails in. A couple of hustlers. One of them short, fat, brunette, named Skinny. The other one was short also.
She was bleached and skinny.
Name of Fat.
Probably. I didn't get it.
They didn't give any pictures, though. Guess you can keep an eye on them.
Okay. Any heads?
Well, Jerry Sachs looked like he was straight. I'm sure he's on it anyway. Didn't see any pushers around the place. Lou said he'd check out on Jerry, sound him out later if he gets any higher.
I guess that's about it.
Okay, go on home and get a good night's sleep, you think.
Okay, so long.
Everyone listen to my new poem. Do you think they really heard it?
I heard it, Mr. Brock.
Thank you, Walter. I'm sure you did.
Bring on the multitude with a multitude of fishes. Feed them to the fishes for liver oil to nourish the artist.
That was word for word.
Is it? I've forgotten.
You mean you don't remember your own poem?
I refuse to say anything twice. Repetition is death.
I don't get it.
When you repeat something, you are reliving a moment, wasting it, severing it from the other end of your life. I believe only in new impressions, new stimuli, new life.
I thought you believed that life is an obscure hobo bumming a ride on a...
I do believe that, Walter, but I also believe creative living. To be uncreative, you might as well be in your grave. Or in the army.
They tried to draft me once. I couldn't pass the test.
Walter, Leonard's looking at you.
He's just about gone.
Walter has a clear mind. One day something will enter it, feel lonely, and leave again.
Too much.
Yes, Katz, yes. If you want to know how beatniks live, William and me will show you. We'll introduce you to some wild ones. You may even discover an artist of your own.
And how much is that going to cost us?
What cost? A couple of bucks. You want to meet some beatniks, don't you?
Oh, no, it's the artist. I'm just crazy about artists.
All that is comes through the eye of the artist. The rest are just blind fish swimming in a cave of aloneness.
Oh, you must be an artist. And working as a busboy, too.
Feed him that he will be satisfied. The artist is. All others are not.
That's most intriguing. Are you a painter?
Well no. I work... I'm working on something that's not ready yet.
What is it, man? Finger painting?
Draw me a picture of a house, Walter. Make some smoke coming out of the chimney.
Well, I am working on something. I'll show you soon.
Walter?
Is he...
Good look, kid. Come on home.
You look awful pale. What'd you have to eat tonight?
I had a salami sandwich, Mrs. Swickard.
Oh, if you were my son, why don't you let me fix you a nice bowl of soup? Won't take but a minute.
Oh, it's okay. I can fix myself something. Besides, I got something important to do.
Oh, say, Walter, did you see anything of Frankie tonight when you went out?
I didn't see him at all.
Well, if you do, tell him I got a nice, fresh piece of halibut for him.
Tell him that? I mean, do you think he'll understand? He's only a cat.
Good night, Walter.
Thank you. Frankie?
Canvas is a canvas or a painting. A rock is a rock or a statue. A sound is a sound or it's music.
What's the matter, Frankie? How'd you get yourself stuck in a wall? Wait a minute, I'll get you out. Poor Mrs. Swickard. She had a nice fresh piece of halibut for you. I'll give you to her in the morning. Repetition is death, Frankie.
By their miserable deaths become the clay within his hands, that he might form an ashtray or an ark. Pray that you might be his diadem, gold, glory, paint, clay, that he might take you in his magic hands and wring from your marrow wonders.
Where are John, Joe, Jim, Jerk? Dead, dead, dead.
Hi, Carla.
Well, Walter, what are you doing here so early?
Well, I brought something. I think you'll like it.
Take that stuff to the laundromat, Walter.
Huh?
Don't mind him. What have you got?
It's a thing I made.
Walter.
You like it?
What's he got?
Oh, come look at this, Leonard.
Where'd you get that, auction?
I made it.
You made that?
I said I did, didn't I?
Walter, very good.
Honest?
Honest.
What's it called?
Dead Cat?
Dead Cat? That's its name?
Sure.
Well, it sure looks dead enough.
You want to buy it?
Buy it?
That thing?
Scare people out of the place.
Don't be silly. It's tremendous. Look at the detail. The anatomy's perfect. Look at the expression on its face.
How come you put a knife into it?
I didn't mean to.
Just got carried away, huh? Well, all right. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll put it in the corner of the alcove. If it sells, we'll split 50-50, okay?
Sure. Does this mean I'm an artist?
Maybe so. You can do other things as well.
All that is comes through the eye of the artist.
Yeah, you're a real artist now. I go in back and scrub down those garbage cans. Much now.
You really like it?
We like it. Now go on.
Did you see my cat?
What's the matter? You losing?
How do you like my cat?
You make this thing mad?
Uh-huh.
It's crazy. Crazy.
You want to buy it?
For me, man?
I'm tapped. He likes my cat.
Get to work.
Hey, Waller. Come here a minute. Hey, congratulations, man.
Walter, you're famous.
I saw your cat.
Did you like it, Mr. Brock?
You may call me Maxwell.
Now, how'd you do it, Walter?
Oh, just took some clay and fixed it up.
Attention. Attention, everyone. As you passed through these yellow portals, I am sure you noticed on your right a small clay figure and assumed this transfixed effigy to be the work of a master sculptor. And indeed, so it is. That master sculptor is in our midst. He is none other than Walter Paisley, our very own busboy, whose hands of genius have been carrying away the empty cups of your frustrations. Mark well this lad. His is the silent voice of creation. Within the dark, rich soil of humility, he blossoms as the hope of our nearly sterile century.
Beautiful, Maxwell.
Bring me an espresso, Walter.
Hey, Maxwell, really beautiful.
Thank you.
Man, you are in.
Oh, Walter, it was wonderful.
Yes, then, cut. Yes. This is my man, took of everything. Yes, yes.
Listen, man, you got a pen?
Huh? This is my man.
Hey, Pops, what's happening?
Making a big scene for Walter.
Who'd he shoot?
He made a cat. Out of clay.
See you around.
Yeah, later.
Somebody clear this table, please. Will somebody clear this table?
Did you hear them, Mr. DeSantis? They all like my cat.
Yeah, very good. Now look, Walter, you must be tired. Why don't you take the rest of the night off? Huh?
No, I don't.
No, you got it coming. Besides, you're creating an incident. When people are applauding, they don't order coffee. So go on home and work on something. Make another cat.
Well, I haven't got another cat.
Well, just go to the movies. Please, Walter, go.
All right, Mr. DeSantis. Good night.
Good night, Walter.
Walter? Walter, wait a minute.
Oh, hello, Naolia.
Walter, I dug it.
My cat?
It was the most wonderful, wildest, like, wiggiest thing I've ever seen. Walter, you've done something to me. Something deep down inside of my prana.
I have?
Oh, Walter, I want to be with you. You're creative. You've got a hot light bulb glowing inside of you, and I want to be warmed by it.
Gee, that's nice of you, Naolia.
Walter, take me away from here. Take me away to some cool blue place. Gas me.
I can't. I gotta go home.
Oh, then I'll go home with you.
Oh, no, Mrs. Swickard wouldn't like that. She's my landlady.
Isn't there anything I can do for you?
I don't think so, Naolia.
Walter, I can't let you just split like this. I've got to do something. I've got to contribute.
You don't have to do anything.
Wait. Wait, there is one thing I can do. One little thing. Don't leave, Walter. I want to give you something. Something that'll make you remember me. Put it in your pocket. Now go, Walter. Don't look back. Just go.
Can I have your autograph, Mr. Paisley?
Why, certainly, my good woman. Everybody likes my cat.
You want to buy my statue, mister? $10,000? Okay.
See, I'll be famous. And then I can ask Carla and she'll say yes. I know she will.
You're Lou, ain't you? I seen you down the yellow door plenty. Come on in. I was just making some pancakes. You can have some if you like. Did you see my cat?
Yeah, I saw your cat. I also saw that chick lay these on you.
Oh, that was Naolia. She's a nice girl. She's kind of strange, though. I guess she figures I get headaches or something.
Okay, Walter, who's your connection?
Connection?
Yeah, connection. Who do you score from? Where do you buy your horse?
Horse?
Horse, junk, white stuff, heroin.
Is that what that is? I never seen any of that before. I always thought that was expensive.
Yeah, Walter, that can be real expensive.
Gee. Well, wasn't that nice of Naolia to give me that expensive horse?
Walter.
Huh?
Police officer.
Ooh. You're like an undercover man.
You're under arrest, Walter.
Under arrest for what?
Possession of narcotics.
For me? What are you talking about?
Walter, I got you cold. Now, you just come along quietly.
I didn't do nothing. And Naolia give me those. I didn't ask her for them.
All
I didn't
right.
even know what was
All
in
right.
that.
All right, you can tell them that downtown. Now, let's go.
I ain't going no place with you.
Walter, do I have to point this at you?
You're going to shoot me. No, don't shoot
Walter,
me.
Walter, just relax.
No, you're going to shoot
now,
me.
Just relax.
No, don't shoot
just
me.
Just shut up, Walter.
No, you're going to shoot me. Don't shoot.
Mrs. Swickard, what noise?
Don't tell me I didn't hear a racket. Are you sure you're all alone?
I'm always alone, Mrs. Swickard.
Walter, have you been talking to yourself again?
Well, I guess maybe I have, Mrs. Swickett. Somebody's got to.
Walter, you know, what you need is a girl. But she doesn't have to be pretty. Just so long as she takes good care of you.
Well, I can take real good care of myself, Mrs. Swickett.
Yeah, I can see that. Look at this pad. It's terrible. When did you ever clean it up? And when did you change these sheets last? They look like they're alive.
Now, Mrs. Swickett, I gotta meet some friends in a little while, and I gotta take a shower.
Well, you know, why don't you clean up
if you don't
this
mind?
Stuff?
Oh, please,
what's
Mrs.
the matter?
Swickett.
Hurt you, Lou. But if you'd have shot me, you'd be mopping up my blood now. I can't help it if I got scared and hit you. I didn't mean it. It's crazy. It's crazy. I didn't know you had it in you, Walter. How'd you do it? Well, I just took some clay and fixed it up. Go home and make something, Walter. Make another cat. But I haven't got another cat.
Well, I reported in here around midnight. Lou had already been gone over an hour. No, nobody seems to know where he went. Why don't you put an alert out on him, and I'll check on him from here. Okay, right.
Age 29, 5'11" tall, dark complexion, hair black and curly. Last seen wearing blue jeans and gray sweater.
Tim Evans was a murderer all in his prison cell. And those who read about his crimes, they damned his soul to hell. Saying, go down, you murderer. And the killing of his own child. The jury found him guilty, and the hanging judge, he smiled.
And dig the fuzz.
What do you suppose they want?
You, man, you.
Hey, maybe they're looking for old Walter. He's a criminal type. Ain't you, Walter?
I'm sorry, Mr. DeSantis.
Oh, that's all right, Walter. Sit down.
Me? Sit down.
Greetings, man.
I'm not supposed to sit with the customers.
Wait. Now, why shouldn't you sit at the table, Walter? After all, you're a big artist now. A true creator above mere mortals.
What's the big idea?
Idea? I was just telling Walter the truth. A man wanted to pay me $100 for the cat. In fact, he's taking it home to show to his wife. Proves that I underestimated Walter's ability. His work? There's enormous realism. You can hardly tell it from the real thing.
Well, that sounds like a real put-down.
Get off Walter's back, Leonard.
Why on his back?
They're not very funny.
I'm not trying to be. Walter, what are you going to make next? A dog, maybe. Or a bird. How about a few dozen cockroaches from your room?
Hey, man, why don't you make an elephant?
I got a new one.
Great. What is it?
It's a full-length, life-size figure.
Crazy. What is it called?
Murdered man.
When do we get to see it?
Oh, anytime.
Hey, that's a pretty far-out name for a statue.
I saw a statue once. It was called The Third Time Phyllis Saw Me, She Exploded.
Well, what kind of a statue was that?
I don't know. It was made out of driftwood and dipped in fluoric acid. Very wild.
What's wrong, Leonard?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
It's the food in this dump.
Oh, man, you should try the Sorel sewer. They got wheat germ bagels. Too much. Excuse me, please.
I think he really is sick.
So who isn't?
Sanders! I've been trying to get to you all evening.
Gotta make a call. Gotta call Lieutenant Valdez.
Listen, I was wrong about my wife. She wants that cat after all. Do you hear me? I'll give you that $100 for the cat.
I can't talk to you just now.
All right, then, $200.
No. No!
$300 and that's tops.
$300 for the cat?
I know I'm going out of my mind, but I've been collecting art pieces all over Europe for years. And this boy, Walter Paisley, has got it. I want to buy his first work. And to make very sure that I get it, I'll pay you $500. $500 for the cat and a first look at his next stuff.
Someone has the cat just now, but I'll have him back in a few days. Then you can have it for the $500.
Oh, thank you, sir. I think I've made a bargain. Call me when you're ready. Good night.
Leonard! Feel better? Listen, I'm going over to Walter's later after the place closes to see Murdered Man. You feel up to coming along?
The rope was fixed around his neck and a washer behind his ear. And the prison bell was tolling, but Tim Evans didn't hear. Saying, go down, you murderer, go down.
Look at the size of it.
Well, it's not really that big. I got it on kind of a stand.
Well, let's see it.
I'm a little nervous. I never did a person before.
You can do anything if you set your mind to it.
It's hot in here.
You want me to open a window?
Oh, come on, Walter. Take off the sheet.
Don't you like it?
Walter, it's a masterpiece. I've never seen anything like it before. And I hope I never see anything like it again.
Neither do I.
It's hideous, and it's eloquent. It expresses modern man and all his self-pity. How did you ever find that in yourself, Walter?
Well, it wasn't easy.
What's the matter with you?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
I've never seen anyone so squeamish. What's your opinion, Leonard?
Don't ask me.
Oh, come on. Now, even you must see its value. Do you think that you or I could have conceived of such a thing, much less executed it? Well, then admit it. It's a work of genius.
I admit it.
Then let's take it down to the yellow door.
No.
Why not?
I'll tell you. But you cover it up again, please, huh? Please.
What is all this nonsense? Why do you want to hide it?
Well, I've been thinking. I didn't realize how much talent Walter actually had. It would be wrong to show his pieces one at a time. Dead wrong.
You're right. He should build a collection first.
Yes. That's the idea. Maybe when it's big enough, we can have a show.
A show?
Yes.
Just for me?
No. Well, not exactly. I mean, you take years and years. It's getting hot again. Well, it would take you years to make that many statues, but your work would be featured.
It's a wonderful idea, Walter. It's the only way to gain recognition. All the big art critics and art dealers will be there. It'll be an event.
Yes, then we can unload. We'd sell this stuff for a lot more.
But the show, how soon can we go?
Well, don't rush things. It takes time. But first of all, you've got to stop making these horrible statues. Carla and I will guide you. Maybe you can turn to freeform.
Freeform?
Well, that's the movement today.
With his talent for realism?
But you can see the direction his realism takes.
It's unhealthy.
But you said I was a genius.
I don't want to be a busboy anymore.
Yes, maybe you got a point there. You shouldn't keep working at the Yellow Door. Look, I'm sure that man is going to buy your dead cat, so here's your fee in advance. $50. And if you need more, I've got it, so don't worry. I've got great faith in you, Walter.
Gee, $50 for something I made.
Now you're a professional.
Let's go.
Okay. Good night, Walter. Keep up the good work.
Yeah, but don't rush things. You got all the time in the world. Come on, Carla.
Good night.
Oh, sure you are, Walter.
I am. Look. Good heavens.
Я цыган, боли поле. Помню я безумные ночи. Здесь не пляс, не дивный звон гитар. И любви пленительный угар.
One of the greatest advances in modern poetry is the elimination of cleric. I am proud to say my poetry is only understood by that minority which is aware.
Aware of what? Why, not of anything, stupid, just aware.
Man, this place is beginning to feel like a lineup.
Yeah, baby. If it don't cool off pretty soon, I'm gonna haunt somebody else's joint.
We may have to start drinking.
Отзвучали песенки цыган. Давно закрыт любимый ресторан.
Yes, man. Yeah. Yes. That's the man. Yeah. Yes, man. Yes.
Good evening, Walter.
Good evening, Paula.
Sylvia, didn't you see me wave my Zen stick?
Walter Paisley.
Bring me a cappuccino and a piece of papaya cheesecake. And a bottle of Yugoslavian white wine.
Yes, sir, Mr. Paisley.
Good evening, Walter.
Maxwell, how have you been?
I see the rewards of achievement have come your way.
Well, after all, I'm a successful sculptor now.
Indeed.
Hey, man, dig Walter the Wigger.
He's coming out like he just cured cancer.
Let us make the scene.
Crazy.
I was just suggesting to Walter that he try his hand at freeform.
Why do you suggest anything to Walter? Are you the spokesman for society come to put your stifling finger in his eye?
Good evening, gentlemen.
Oh, well, now, who invited these two down from the clouds?
Maxwell, yoo-hoo!
Through the table, bring a bowl. I may be sick.
It's Alice the Awful comes to spread cheer and color.
Look at my suntan, everybody.
Do we have to?
Where have you been, Alice?
I went up to Big Sur to look for Henry Miller.
You didn't find him, I hope.
No, he's in Europe.
Good.
Why is the busboy sitting here?
I'm not the busboy anymore.
That's right. Walter has become a sculptor.
Oh, really? I'm a model, you know. I only charge $25 an hour. Would you like to do me?
I just might.
Never mind that. Walter's gonna try freeform.
There you go again. I may take my business to the Sorrel Sewer.
As a matter of fact, I was going to suggest to Walter that he try a female figure. As a change from the violent death theme. You really should, Walter. You know what? If you like, I'll be your model for free.
I couldn't. Not you.
Man, if you're gonna be an artist, you've gotta do nudes, nudes.
Right. Ain't nobody an artist unless he does
nude.
Will you get them out of here before we wind up in night court?
Oh, let's change the subject. I'm sick of hearing about sculpture. Nobody knows how to do that anymore, much less the busboy from the Yellow Door.
Who do you think you're talking about?
Don't shout at me.
I don't like you.
Nobody asked for your opinion, Walter. You're just a simple little farm boy, and the rest of us are all sophisticated beatniks.
That's all, man. Let's split.
Yeah, man. I gotta make me some air.
See, you made them leave.
What did I do?
The first beneficial service of your benighted life. It proves we're all good for something.
Are you saying that this busboy is better than I?
Yes.
I think this whole bit about him being a sculptor is just a big put-on for my benefit.
That's not true. I am a sculptor.
Oh, yeah? Prove it. Make something out of this.
There. Hand.
That isn't a real hand. If you were a sculptor, you'd create something for me.
A harpoon would be very nice.
I'm going home.
Alice?
You're obnoxious.
But he's such an idiot. What are you doing here?
I wanted to apologize for being nasty to you this evening.
So you're apologized. Good night. Listen, Torp, why don't you get out of here and let me go to bed?
I didn't finish talking to you. I decided to make that female figure after all.
Oh?
And I'd like you to pose for it.
Remember what I said about my price?
$25 an hour.
If you want to pay it, I don't mind posing. When do you want to start work?
Tonight.
You mean right now?
Uh-huh.
Wait till I get my sweater. More heat around this place.
It's bad for the clay. You'll get used to it.
Well, I'm almost ready.
Here. Sit in this chair and I'll pose you.
Rickety. How's this pose?
Well, that's fine. It's very good. Just stay like that.
That doesn't look like very much clay.
Oh, it's enough. Put this around your neck.
Watch it, the plate's hot.
Are these fertile eggs?
Are these eggs fertile? Naturally.
What'd you fry them in?
We ran out of the safflower seed oil, but I found a bottle of peanut oil on the shelf. Don't worry, it's not hydrogenated.
Is that the cold press stuff or the junk Hilda bought by mistake?
Yes, man, yes. Hi.
Good morning, Walter.
Hi, Walter. What
that brings you here?
Had some breakfast, man.
What are you having?
Soy and wheat germ pancakes, organic guava nectar, calcium lactate and tomato juice, and garbanzo omelets sprinkled with smoked yeast. Join us?
No, thanks. Mm. Sounds great, though. Mm. I brought something to show you. Could I have some of the guys help me?
Is it murdered, man?
It's better.
Come on.
Porters! Put it in the middle of the room.
When did you do this, Walter?
Last night. It doesn't take me very long.
I should say not.
Well, let's see it, man.
Walter, I can't believe it.
I'm honored to know this man.
Do you think it's nice?
Hey, she's beautiful.
Do you think it's nicer than murdered man?
Oh, I don't know, Walter. It's impossible to choose. They're both great.
Walter, I'm deeply moved. To show my appreciation, I'm going to give a party tonight at the Yellow Door, in your honor. And I shall compose a poem.
More champagne, Your Majesty?
Here, here.
Where?
There, there. Fine. Man, let's have another little kiss.
Walter, you're a wretch.
Yeah.
Here I go. Right. Here we go. The bird that flies now pays later through the nose of ambidextrous apathy. Necrophiles may dance upon the placemats in an orgy of togetherness. The highway of life cuts sharply through the shady ghettos and the ivy-covered tombs, and laughter rings from every time capsule in the star-spangled firmament. And in the deep freeze, it is the children's hour, and no one knows that Duncan is murdered. And no one knows that Walter Paisley is born. Duncan knows. Tuesday sunrise knows. Alley cats and garbage cans and steaming pavements and you and I and the nude descending the staircase and all such things with souls. We know that Walter Paisley is born. Ring rubber bells, beat cotton gongs, strike silken cymbals. Play leathern flutes, the cats and cans, and you and I, and all such things with souls. We shall hear, Walter Paisley is born, and the souls become flesh. Walter Paisley is born.
Marvelous, darling, marvelous.
Man. Like that was the greatest gas I ever heard.
Crazy, what did he say?
Didn't you hear him?
No, man, I'm too far out.
Maxwell, that was magnificent.
I feel so elegant.
Walter deserved every word of it.
It makes me so glad I'm aware.
Did you hear what he said?
Yes, Walter.
All about me. It's true, isn't it?
Every word.
You better hold off on the bubbly, Curtis.
Yeah, why?
You might talk too much.
What would I say?
Most anything, I expect.
Are you two trying to ignore the rest of us?
Oh, not me, Maxwell. I wouldn't ignore you. I know what it is to be ignored.
Tell us what you're going to do next, Walter.
I'm gonna make the most wonderful, wildest, wiggiest things you've ever seen. I'm gonna make big statues and little statues, tall statues and short statues. I'm gonna make statues of nobodies and statues of famous people, statues of actors and poets and people who sell things on television, and a statue of the mayor and some opera singers and their intimate friends. And everybody will say, Walter, let me shake your hand.
It's been a real pleasure to have known you. Alley cats and garbage cans, they know that Walter Paisley is born. Ring rubber bells, beat cotton gongs, strike silken cymbals, play leathern flutes. Tell us what you're gonna do next, Walter. I'm gonna make big statues, little statues, movie stars and poets, and guys who sell things on television. And the mayor, and some officers. What you gonna do next, Walter? What am I gonna do next? What am I gonna do next? I gotta do something before they forget. I know what it's like to be ignored.
Obscure hobo, bumming a ride on the omnibus of art.
Huh? What'd you say?
What is not creation is graham crackers. Let them all crumble to feed the creator.
Oh, bait it, you must be nuts.
You got in the box.
Just wait till you see this.
Extra, extra. Horrible murder at Furniture Factory. Read about the man who got cut in half. Extra, extra. Police can only find part of it.
Leonard.
Read all about it.
What's the matter, Leonard?
You made a bust.
Yeah, isn't it wonderful? What's the matter, Leonard?
Put it down, Walter, please.
Walter. Walter, listen to me carefully. I don't want you to make any more statues. Do you understand? No more statues.
Well, why not? I gotta make statues, Leonard. You heard Brock. They want me to make them. If I stop making them, I'll just be a busboy again.
Brock, he's behind all of this with his stupid, bitter poetry. Listen, you've got to stop him right away. I'm beginning to feel responsible.
Why? What did you do?
Never mind. Walter, I've decided to have that show for you right away. Yes. When Carla comes, we'll have her work up some nice invitations. We'll have them printed up. We'll invite the critics and the art collectors. We'll tell them.
Well, I don't see why we can't go.
Mr. Leonard DeSantis is afraid to have you come. You who buy his coffee and lure his tourists. You are the heart and soul and meat of the Yellow Door. He slighted you.
Did you get an invitation?
I did not. But I'm going anyway. Not to drink his champagne, but to see Walter's triumph. After that, we go no more.
Hi, Maxwell.
I won't say good luck, Walter.
Why not?
It would imply you could not succeed on your ability alone.
You look so handsome.
I do. So do you. I mean, you look so pretty.
Oh, thank you.
Are you ready?
Oh, we've got plenty of time.
I know, but I wanted to talk to you.
Okay. We can go now if you like. Bye.
Later, man, later.
Swing.
Man, why do you suppose Walter wants to get her alone?
Do you suppose he could be physically attracted to her?
No, man, he ain't the type. He don't get enough vitamin E.
Maxwell gave him a bottle of wheat germ oil once. Maybe he just started taking it.
What did you want to talk to me about, Walter?
Well,
what kind of people do you like, Carla?
Oh, thinking people. Artistic people, I guess.
You think I'm artistic?
Of course I do.
That means you like me.
I like you very much, Walter.
I thought you did. I count how you kissed me the other night.
Oh, that was for your sculptor of the girl. You're nude in the chair.
Carla, I've been alone for a long time, and I know you've been alone, because you never seem to go out with anybody, even though Leonard's always asking you to go out with him, and I just...
What are you trying to say?
Carla, I don't want to make statues anymore. I want to get married to you.
How long have you been thinking about this, Walter?
Oh, for a long time. Ever since you first came to work at the club. You were the only one who was ever nice to me. I didn't know you loved me until you kissed me.
Walter, I do like you. And I did kiss you. But that was because of your work. There's more to being in love with someone than just that.
You mean you don't love me?
I'm afraid that's what I mean.
But you gotta love me. Why do you think I made that statue of Alice?
Walter, I'm sorry, but
you just can't be sorry. I want to marry you.
Now, calm down, Walter, and let's go in there, and then maybe when the show's over, we can talk about it.
Well, tomorrow. I don't want to talk about it.
I get it. I see the whole thing now. Nobody knows that Walter Paisley is born.
Carla, will you do one favor for me?
Just about anything, Walter.
Would you let me make a statue of you?
Would you really like to? That'd make me very happy.
Okay. Tonight. I'll make a statue of you tonight. Okay?
Come on.
Return to realism.
Yes, a one-man return. We have many artists about, but no craftsmen. This man knows his anatomy.
I'd give $1,500 for this.
After you read my review, it'll probably cost you $5,000.
So what's the trouble?
Why should you be so depressed? Have you heard the things they're saying? You can make $25,000 on these pieces alone.
I thought you put money down.
I do, but $25,000?
Oh, leave me alone.
Out!
Man, we have come to make this scene.
Want some cappuccino, man? We got the bread.
We're not open for business. This is an art exhibit. No bums. Get out.
That art is a bum, man.
And he's sober.
Yeah, well, that's his problem.
All right, man, all right. We'll wait outside.
Yeah, you wait outside.
Carla?
What's the matter?
Walter, there's a body inside.
inside that statue.
Oh, that's Alice. It's all right, Carla. Maxwell says it's all right. Let them become clay in his hands that he might mold them.
Walter, you stay away from me.
Don't you see, Carla? I made them immortal. Don't you see? I can do the same for you.
I'm going with you.
Hey, man, what is the score?
Walter Paisley's a murderer.
Ah, man, I saw him chasing Carla down the street.
Walter, go home.
He won't know where else to go.
Walter, go home.
Where is he?
We'll have him soon, Lou.
We'll teach him he can't murder us and get away with it, won't we?
Walter. What you gonna do now, Walter?
Find me.
suppose he would have called it Hanging Man. His greatest work.